Mic test. All right. Back to Tales of Berseria. After how long? How long has it been? Really, how long has it been? I played this. We gotta go rest. Wherever do we rest at? Hold on, turn on. There we go. First floor. Okay. So we gotta go inside. Alright, so that's right. We end up back on that prison island that they made their home base. So, again, for those of you who don't remember, I gotta be extra careful when I play this game. There's a lot of cutscenes that I'll end up getting in trouble for if I'm. We gotta make our way to B2. That's where we gotta go. So B1. How do we get to B2? Oh, okay, so we're going the right way.
Kurigane!
More complaining is...
Come on, don't be like that. Every time I turn around, Velvet or one of the pirates is telling me to go make some delivery to some island.
Isn't that just a sign they think you're a dependable guy?
Maybe, but I don't see them sending you off on errands. It's like they take one look at your face and decide to leave you alone.
I don't have a face.
Oh, right, sorry.
Maybe you just don't know how much work I do around here. It's more than you think. Anything to do with iron, I do it. What do you take me for? Some kind of...
You're too funny! But doesn't it ever annoy you to have all these kids giving you orders?
I've spent my entire life thinking of nothing but forging swords. They can be a hassle.
Yeah, that's what I thought. But I've been too nice, so they keep pushing work onto me.
I don't have it.
That's not the point!
The only reason why I'm being careful is because I didn't want to start this. I just wanted to get that item that was next to him.
Then go on and get off this ship with your tail.
Yeah, except I don't have a tail right now.
I didn't really want to see that. I just wanted to get that item that was next to him. I got a good question. How come this place did not dry out yet? I got puddles of water in here. Going in the right direction. Only one place I can go. Okay, I'm on B2. Just somewhere. Probably gotta take this turn, because I don't really see. Am I going to the right place? It's D3.
Don't push yourself too hard now, Lafayette. You hear me?
I hear you. I just...
Okay, I'm in the right place.
I told everyone I could find the Therians, but... I've only sent us to the wrong places. Aizen, is there any way to boost Amalok's powers?
I guess it's okay for me to tell you this. The majority of Malakim today have their consciousnesses sealed away to be used as mere tools for the exorcists. But originally, Malakim were beings who received prayers from people, and in return bestowed their blessings upon nature and mankind.
So you're saying that when humans pray to a Malak, the Malak receives great strength?
Yes. In general, at least. Some Malakim, like me, buck the system and bring about misfortune rather than divine grace.
Oh, that's unfortunate. But who would ever pray to me?
Maybe you didn't lead us to any Therians, Fee, but it's not like we came back empty-handed. We found Orichalcum to use against Shigure, and we also learned we can hold our own against a dragon.
Velvet!
So where should we go next, Fee?
Northgand! There's a big Earth Pulse point north of Helavis!
Works for me. Aizen?
We can leave whenever you want. Doesn't matter to me.
And I'm all set. Let's make our way to the harbor.
When I say prayers, I don't mean outright worshipping. All I'm talking about are earnest thoughts and feelings directed at you.
I see. So I'm already receiving prayers then.
Now we can just leave. Great. This way. For those of y'all wondering what this little smoky stuff is, I use an item called a holy bottle. Supposedly it's supposed to keep away encounters from weak monsters. But it doesn't really work the way it's supposed to. Either that or the areas I'm in are just not composed, or the areas that I'm in at this point aren't considered to be with weak monsters, so.
Thanks to you, the construction of our hideout is proceeding so smoothly.
About that retractable ventilation shutter. Please, let me make a new one.
What? Why? We already installed it, and it works just fine.
It's the hinges. When they move, it makes this unbearable squeak. I can hear it every time the wind blows.
Oh, come on! That's nothing! Besides, anything we install is going to rust up once the sea breeze gets to it. More importantly, I'd love it if you made us a nice big pot and a frying pan too.
Not happening. I can't focus with that incessant squeaking. I can't work under these conditions.
Fine. You can make a new shutter. But make us a pot and pan while you're at it.
Can I also fix that autonomous hunter-killer anti-personnel spinning blade engine I made the other day?
That too? But you said you were satisfied with how it turned out.
I was at first, but when I thought about it, I realized I forgot to install an off switch. So, can I fix it?
God, yes! Fix it before it kills us all!
Great. Okay.
Spinning death machine first!
I think I went the wrong way. I did. Good boy.
Next target is north of Helaviz, near the Faldi's ruins. In light of everything we know, I'd say it's highly likely we'll find a Therian there.
Let's hope!
Then we should make our first stop, Port Helaviz.
With the, mischief we got into last time, getting into the city might prove difficult.
Benwick, how are things in Helaviz right now?
That shipping guild that used to handle our mooring is pretty much toast, but for some reason, the Abbey isn't watching the port as much as they once were. Unfamiliar ships have been hauling in relief supplies, so if we pose as one of the transport ships, I think we can slip in. And if we divert some supplies to an unofficial channel, we might be able to secure a new mooring partner.
Smuggling in relief supplies for our own disaster. Cheeky bastards, aren't we?
It's what'll get us in.
That
yes, we are. We are some cheeky bastards.
Roger. I'll get right on it.
So, I thought I was close to beating this. I am nowhere near.
The supplies are loaded. We can make for Helaviz whenever you want.
That was fast.
If we weren't hard workers, we wouldn't be sailors.
Eleanor!
Oh, what's wrong, Kamoana?
She said she had a dream about her mom.
When Mommy saw me, she said I looked scary.
No.
Your mother would never say that, sweetheart.
Sure she would. I mean, I would.
But
you're hideous.
How can you be sure?
I mean, you got an eye of a star and you got another normal eye, like...
I put it. I know because I know.
I know because I know.
You're just lying to make me feel better.
Well, since you know that, feel better, damn it.
Aw, Kamoana, don't cry.
Look, I have a halo. Don't cry because I have.
This is the part I hate about little kids.
I'm not a little kid! I hate you, Velvet! I hate you!
That's right. Let it all out.
Stop it! Stop it!
That was weird.
She managed to cry herself to sleep.
They're not rational creatures. Sometimes you just gotta let them cry it out.
You seem used to it.
I guess you could say that. Luffy usually kept himself together when he was younger. But when he was really little, he had times like this every now and then. And on that note, let's take off all we can.
My liege, Dial, I leave Kamalana in your care.
I'll do what I can, but kids as sweet and honest as her are harder to deal with than corrupt bureaucrats.
An outlaw prince and a talking lizard are no replacement for a mother.
Yay, we're off. We're away from all the bullshit.
I do hope Kamalana isn't crying any... Yeah. Shush.
How long is it going to be before you send in another exorcist to replace Lady Teresa?
With these demons clamoring at our gates, none of us feel safe anymore.
You have our deepest sympathies, but we were sent here on a different mission.
That's what the last exorcist who came here said before leaving for the north. What could be up there that's worth all that attention?
Surely we're not all being punished by the Abbey for what happened with Medissa, are we?
That is not the case. Now, if you'll excuse us, we have business to attend to.
Wow, that was a nonchalant brush off.
So the exorcists are just passing through town and heading straight north. Odd.
Ever since the Calamity showed up, everything's just gone to pot, I say.
Calamity? What do you mean?
I mean the demon who barged in and made a mess of our fair city. She's a nasty creature of pure evil, with an arm that eats anything that gets in her way.
Haven't you heard of her? The Calamity's been rampaging across the whole kingdom, not just here. Scant few have seen her and survived.
Huh. You don't say.
After the Calamity raised our ships and our port, the shipping guild fell apart, and our trade routes got poached by other ports. It's bad. The town relies on trade to make ends meet.
People are abandoning the city, and our streets are no longer safe. Not to mention the demon blight spreading again. Just the other day, a little kid turned into a demon. Just like that. What a world! What a world!
What have the exorcists been doing during all of this?
Well, Lady Teresa was in charge of this region, but she came up short against the Calamity and got a fat demotion for her troubles. Several new exorcists have been reassigned here, but once they arrive, they all traipse right off to the ruins up north.
This has to be Medissa's fault. If she hadn't gone and done something so stupid...
Medissa...
That's enough. This isn't something for outsiders to know.
You're right. Sorry. I'm really worried about what's going to come of this town.
It sounds like Hellevis isn't what it used to be these days.
We need to ask around and find out more about what's going on here.
Agreed. Especially regarding the Abbey and those ruins. I'm also curious about this Medissa woman.
The ruins part makes sense, since the Earth Pulse point might be there. But why do you care who Medissa is?
Just a hunch. Something tells me she's worth looking into.
You're not gonna look into this Calamity chick? She sounds like a real terror.
Yeah, I think I'll pass. I already know plenty about what makes her tick.
Uh-huh. Hey, speak. Tell me what happened.
Do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
Sorry, I'm busy. Try someone else.
Excuse me. My name is Eleanor, and I'm an exorcist on patrol with the Abbey. I was wondering if I could solicit your honest opinion about how this town is being run.
Oh, I didn't realize there was an exorcist with you. Yes, please tell the Abbey we want Lady Teresa back. Her governance was strict, it's true, but at least we could live in safety. Now, all the exorcists run off to the Faldi's ruins and leave us here in the lurch. They value some dusty, faraway ruins over the lives of the good, hardworking citizens here. It's just wrong. We've always been cooperative with the Abbey's demands, and now this is what we get in return.
I see. The Abbey appreciates your, candor. I'll pass your comments on to my superiors.
Right, so I guess that'll be Velvet and others.
Poor Medissa.
Are you a friend of hers?
Yeah, she used to live just down the road from me. Medissa raised her daughter Diana all on her own. And then they up and murdered the girl.
Murdered? By whom?
The exorcists. Once Diana caught the demon blight, the damned Abbey exterminated her like a rat.
How cruel.
I felt just terrible. But I suppose there wasn't much else to be done with her. But Medissa, she hated the Abbey for what they'd done. So she barricaded herself inside the sanctuary. She just kept on screaming, all like, demons have feelings too.
What happened after that?
I wouldn't have been surprised to see her executed. But luckily, she was spared that much. An exorcist stopped the guard who was about to cut her down, said, "Don't kill her. She's receptive."
Receptive, huh?
I think that's their way of referring to her deep faith. Before all this, she was a real devout lady.
That was certainly kind of them.
Medissa really cherished her daughter. Can't much blame her for blowing up like that. But the Abbey, they don't care so much about feelings. Reason is all that matters to them. They don't take kindly to people disrupting their order.
All right. Oh.
If you go north from Hellebees, you'll come upon the Faldi's ruins, which are Abbey property. Mainly, it's used as a checkpoint for hauling ore that's extracted out of Mount Killerhouse. But between you and me, I hear the Abbey also uses it as a prison camp.
A prison camp? Are they capturing demons?
Heavens no! The demons they kill on sight. No, these prisoners are human criminals. Not long ago, this woman killed someone and locked herself up in the sanctuary. I hear she got hauled off to the camp.
Why do you think the Abbey would use the ruins for a prison camp?
Who knows? Maybe they need a place to deal out their harshest punishments. The Abbey's not known to be forgiving, after all. But these are just nasty rumors I heard. Of course, I don't believe a word of it.
Right. We're gonna look into it anyway.
I can't believe the demon blight has spread into the city now.
Scary times.
Well, the one who caught it was a little girl. Were able to deal with her before anything bad happened. But the problem was that the demon girl's mother tried to hide her.
That's only human nature.
These are dangerous times. We dare not let our emotions control us. One person's selfishness could endanger the entire community.
Oh, right.
Thankfully, an upstanding citizen noticed something suspicious and reported the child to the Abbey. But the mother went mad and killed him in retribution. And what makes it all the more lurid is, I heard the man she killed was a fellow she was actually thinking about marrying. The daughter had been dead set against her mother remarrying. You can taste the irony.
That's horrible.
She had it coming. If there's anything worse than demons, it's people who can't control themselves.
So, Diana was a girl-turned-demon who was killed by an exorcist. And her mother Medissa hated the Abbey for it. And the Abbey is using the Faldi's ruins up north as a prison camp.
It's a lot like what happened to Kamuana, isn't it?
It's natural for a mother to love her own child. To make that a crime.
What I'm curious about is the use of the word receptive to describe Medissa.
So long as there is one receptive to divine power,
Therians shall be forever reborn. If our interpretation of that ancient book is right, it likely means she's receptive to Enominat's power.
Meaning they brought Odessa to those ruins where there's an Earth Pulse point, and then they made her into a Therian.
That would certainly put all the pieces together, yep. Plus, if this Therian the Abbey created already hates them, that's all the better for us.
Yeah, I imagine she'd be willing to work with us. Although, it sounds almost too easy. Did I jinx it? I just jinxed it, didn't I?
Probably, but we won't find out until we try.
True. Let's head for the ruins.
And don't worry, you totally jinxed it.
Alright. Hold up. Get up and fix myself.
The Faldi's ruins are north of Helavis. The Earth Pulse point is...
He'll be pretty good. I think he'll be pretty good. Gotta keep the water out.
Is to the north, too. Probably in the very same place.
No guards. I think it's a good thing or a bad thing.
I'd say good. We can march straight in.
I don't think we have a chance!
Place the place.
You don't want to make me angry.
Laffy said apologize for losing your temper.
Oh, sorry.
Come on, let the boy try to act tough.
There sure are a lot of Malakim posted here.
They're probably here to protect the Therian, right?
One would assume.
The exorcist controlling them can't be far then. Be careful.
Alright. It didn't pause, did it? Nope. difficult. Drinking me some of my smoothie. Damn, all of them. Cats. Freaking cats. Hot.
This Nordahl. It looks a lot like Grimoire and Bienfu. But there's something different about it that I can't quite put my finger on.
I agree. Those two are positively gloomy, but this doll seems calming, yet glamorous, too.
Like I said, a quiet radiance.
Yeah. You think so? I think it's more lethargic or absent-minded. Like it can't tell what's going on in its head. Either way, I'm 1,000 times cuter than that thing.
What's cute about you? People who keep their faces covered are creepy.
I don't know. There's definitely something off about it. It's charming, but a little ominous. Like I can never entirely be at ease around it, if that makes sense.
You think so? Actually, I think it's cute. It reminds me of a little baby.
You think this looks like a baby?
I remember when my sister was about as small as that doll. She had the tiniest little hands, and she tried to grip my pinky as best she could.
Really?
I'd take my pinky with her fingers wrapped around it and poke her cheek, and she'd just be all smiles. I swore to myself I'd always do whatever I could to protect her. Once she got a little older and started fixing meals, lots of weird things began to happen around us. Wherever we went, she was in danger. Demons attacked us. A dragon tried to kidnap her. That's when I first realized what it was that I carried. That the cause of all my sister's pain was my blessing, my Reaper's curse.
So, you left her behind and went on your search for a way to break the curse.
Right. And that's when I met Eifried. It was from him that I first heard about the Nordahls. He thought the stories about them were all just baseless rumors.
I guess we'll never know for sure unless we gather them all. But...
Hmm? What is it?
I think something good will happen once they're all together.
Why do you say that?
Well, because we found this doll, you shared some of your past with us. That makes me kinda happy. So I think we should get the other three, so more happy stuff happens.
Hard to argue with you there.
Alright, we got one doll. Going in the right direction. Uh, Nothing. I thought something else was going to be right there, but apparently not. There we go. Holy bottle. Wow, I completely botched that. Hold on.